In this video, we will derive the parallel axis theorem of classical mechanics. The moment of inertia for a rigid body rotating around its center of mass is given by the integral of r perpendicular squared dm, which can be written as rho dv. R perpendicular is the shortest distance from a volume element dv to the axis of rotation, let's call it A. But what if the object is rotating around a different axis, B, which does not go through the center of mass? Well, in this case, we can use the parallel axis theorem, or Steiner's theorem, which saves us from doing another integration. Let's derive it. The moment of inertia through the axis B is given by the integral over r perpendicular squared rho dv, where r perpendicular is now the vector from the axis B to the volume element. Instead of calculating this, we use the following trick. We write the vector r perpendicular as a plus rcv, where a points from the axis B to the center of mass, and rcv points from the center of mass to the volume element dv. If we expand this, we get three terms. The first one is simply the moment of inertia through the center of mass, since the vector rcv starts at the center of mass. For the second term, we can recognize the definition for the center of mass position. But since the origin of the coordinate system for rcv lies on the center of mass, remember, rcv starts from the center of mass, therefore this is its origin, we get the vector 0, 0, 0. And for the last term, the integral over the density is just the total mass of the object. There we have it. The moment of inertia around any random axis is given by the moment of inertia around a parallel axis that goes through the center of mass, plus the object's total mass multiplied by the distance between the center of mass and the axis of rotation squared. One last thing to mention is that the last term itself can be interpreted as the moment of inertia for a point particle. So, for a rotation around a random axis, we can pretend that the whole object is concentrated in the center of mass, and then add the moment of inertia for a rotation around the center of mass. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching!